Hello students, welcome. This is the 7th lecture for the chapter Current Electricity. In this video, we will discuss about the uses of potentiometer, and here I explain the first use of potentiometer, that is to compare the EMF of cells. We know that what is potentiometer. In the last video, you have learned about it, that potentiometer is a device that is used to measure a EMF of a cell, and the potentiometer works as it is a device that works as a voltmeter, but not it works as an ideal voltmeter. And you know that the ideal voltmeter has the infinite resistance. We can increase the resistance of potentiometer more than that of the voltmeter, and so the potentiometer will be used to measure the smallest EMF, smallest voltage than the voltmeter. So what is potentiometer? आपने इसका पिक्चर भी लास्ट वीडियो में देखा है कि पोटेंशियोमीटर क्या है. इन द पोटेंशियोमीटर देयर इज अ मेटल वायर ऑफ यूनिफॉर्म क्रॉस सेक्शन एंड हैविंग लेंथ नियर अबाउट 4 मीटर टू 10 मीटर वायर हैविंग यूनिफॉर्म क्रॉस सेक्शन कट इनटू 4 पीसेस और 10 पीसेस ईच पीस हैविंग लेंथ 1 मीटर एंड दैट पीसेस दैट वायर्स आर फिक्स ऑन अ wooden platform with the help of copper strips in a zigzag way, and that gives us the instrument that is the potentiometer. We will draw here the diagram of potentiometer. We draw the 4 single lines. This is the first wire, suppose. This is the second wire, this is the third wire, and this is the fourth wire. Okay, each wire has the length 1 meter. This is the starting point of the wire. We call this point as A, and this is our end point of the wire. We call this point as B. This is your point A and this is your point B. That is the end point of the wire, and we have cut the wire 4 meter wire. Hum yahan 4 meter wire ka potentiometer dekhenge. 4 meter wire is cut into 4 equal pieces, having each piece having length 1 meter. Now this is the first wire. At the end, these two wires, the ends of the two wires are connected by the metal strip that is made of copper or steel. Is that? Thus, the two wires are in contact with each other. Now we can see that the wire is uniform. Now at this point, again we connect a metal strip. The wire is joined with the help of metal strips, so that the current from this wire should enter in the third wire. Now this is your fourth wire. Again here we use the metal strip, and this whole arrangement is fixed on a wooden board. Now this is your potentiometer. 4 meter wire hai, copper strip or steel strips hai na, we use the copper strips or steel strips to connect the wire so that the wire is straight. We can consider the wire is straight. And here this whole arrangement is fixed on a wooden platform, and a scale is given here parallel to the length of the wire so that we can measure the length of the wire. Basically, in the primary circuit of the potentiometer, in each case we have to connect the battery, key and rheostat in series with the wire AB. Across this wire AB, suppose here we connect a battery, high potential point, that is the positive terminal of the battery we connect here, and the negative terminal of the battery we connect to a key. This is your key. Now this is your battery having EMF E, and here we connect a rheostat. With the help of rheostat we can vary the resistance in the circuit, and so that we can change the current that flowing through the wire, and the point B is connected to the variable terminal of potentiometer. This is your battery, key and rheostat. When we close the key, what happened here? When we close the key, the current from this positive terminal of the cell will flow from this point here and enter through the wire, go in this direction. Now from this first wire at the end, last video bhi humne explain kiya hai ye. Here is the first wire, the current goes from left side to right side. From these steel strips, it enters here. Now in the second wire, the direction of current is from right to left. Again in the third wire, yahan se current yahan enter hoga. यहां देखो द करंट फ्लोज फ्रॉम लेफ्ट एंड टू राइट एंड अगेन एंड इन द फोर्थ वायर अगेन द करंट फ्लोज फ्रॉम राइट टू लेफ्ट कम्स टू पॉइंट बी अगेन कम्स थ्रू द रियोस्टेट टू द बैटरी. दिस इज द प्राइमरी सर्किट ऑफ पोटेंशियोमीटर एंड वी नो दैट द डेफिनेशन ऑफ पोटेंशियल ग्रेडियंट एंड व्हाट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पोटेंशियोमीटर. The definition of potential gradient is potential difference per unit length across the potentiometer wire, that is called as potential gradient. And what is the principle of potentiometer? In the potentiometer, the voltage between any two points, suppose we consider this is your point A and this is your point B. This is the total wire 4 meter suppose and it is connected to a battery, key and rheostat. यहां से करंट स्टार्ट हो रहा है. नाउ वी कंसीडर एनी पॉइंट सी ऑन द वायर. द वोल्टेज बिटवीन दिस पॉइंट ए एंड सी वी ए सी इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू इट्स लेंथ बिटवीन दैट टू पॉइंट. दैट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पोटेंशियोमीटर. द वोल्टेज बिटवीन एनी टू पॉइंट्स ऑन द वायर इज डायरेक्टली प्रोपोर्शनल टू द लेंथ ऑफ द वायर बिटवीन दैट टू पॉइंट्स. व्हेन द करंट फ्लोइंग थ्रू द वायर रिमेन्स कॉन्स्टेंट, when the temperature of the wire remains constant and also the wire having uniform cross-sectional area. These are the conditions and this is the principle of potentiometer. We can use this principle of potentiometer and here we have to use, we come, see here, the point is that to compare the EMF of cells, we can take the two cells. Suppose in the lab we can consider there one cell is the Daniell cell and another is the Lackland cell. You know that you are learning the chemistry. The Lackland cell has the EMF more than the Daniell cell. Daniell cell has the EMF near about 1 volt approximately. And the Lackland cell has the EMF near about 1.2 volt. We choose the cell having greater EMF as E1. Lackland cell jo bottle mein rehta hai, use hum E1 bolenge. Aur wo jo copper vessel wala cell hai, use Daniell cell, that we consider as E2 here. So we connect that two cells, the positive terminal of that two cells. See here, this is the basic circuit. When we take the comparison of EMF of two cell by separate method, by sum and difference method, and to find the internal resistance of a cell by using potentiometer, this is the basic circuit that is common in all three cases. And now the secondary circuit here. Now this point A is connected to the two cells. We connect this to the two cells. You can see the diagram in your book also. Both the positive terminal of the cell E1 and E2 are connected to this point A. See here, now there are the three connections at this point A. Battery ka positive, cell E1 ka positive, cell E2 ka positive, all that are connected at points A. And the negative terminals are connected to the two-way key. This is the single-way key. And in the two-way key, there are the two gaps and the center point we can connect to the galvanometer. The first gap, we called it as K2, suppose second, and this is gap K1. Is that? And this is your K2. Just a minute, sorry. K2. Now, this terminal, second, which ka terminal jo hai, we connect it to the galvanometer and galvanometer ko hum connect karenge jockey. Jockey is a metal point. We use the pointer that is to make the contact at any point on the wire. This is the basic circuit. Now, when we compare the EMF of two cell, we can describe here in the description, if there is a question in board that explain the use of potentiometer with the help of how you can compare the EMF of two cell by using the potentiometer by separate method. This is the separate method or individual method. We can say connect the circuit as shown in figure. Connect a battery, key and rheostat. This is the rheostat in series with the wire AB of potentiometer. Then connect the two cells E1 and E2 and a two-way key and a galvanometer and jockey as shown in figure. Or we can say the positive terminal of the cells are connected to point A, that is the higher potential point here. The central point of the two-way key is connected to the galvanometer and another terminal of galvanometer is connected to the jockey. And now your circuit is ready. And how you can compare the EMF of two cell? When the circuit is on, close the key K, and now here there are the two gaps. We close this K1 close करेंगे और ये K2 जो है ये अपना open रहेगा. As the K2 is open, E2 is not in the circuit now and E1 will be in the circuit only. Is that? As K1 is closed and K2 is open, the cell E1 is in the circuit and E2 is not in the circuit. Then we touch the jockey at different points on the wire by sliding it, by moving it. When we connect the jockey at different points on the wire, we observe the zero deflection in the galvanometer. And suppose at any point, suppose this at this point, we get the deflection in the galvanometer. Suppose this is your point P1, for which the galvanometer shows zero deflection, center ko zero deflection. We can call this point as null point for the cell E1. We can measure the length of the wire AP1. What will be the length of the wire AP1? Obviously, we know that. That is between 200 to 300 centimeter, because each wire has the length 100 centimeter. अगर null point second wire पे हमें मिलेगा, तो null point की length होगी 100 to 200 के बीच में. Third wire पे 200 to 300. If the null point is on the fourth wire, then the balancing length will be between 300 to 400. Here we can say measure the length of the wire AP1, and suppose we consider the length of the wire AP1 that is equal to L1. Now as the length of the wire AP1 is L1, we can say this E1, EMF of the cell E1 is balanced by the voltage between the point AP1, and therefore we can say the E1 is equal to K into L1, where K is the potential gradient. Potential gradient means potential difference per unit length. Means 1 centimeter length of the wire has the voltage. What is the voltage of 1 centimeter of wire? That is potential gradient, and we consider that is K. Agar 1 centimeter ka voltage itna hoga, to 340 centimeter, 240 centimeter, 250 centimeter, 270 centimeter wire, usse hum multiply karenge potential gradient se, to hume milega total voltage, that is between point A to P1, and that is equal to E1, and therefore we can say E1 is equal to K into L1. In some books or in the old syllabus book, it is given E1 is equal to I sigma L1. How it is find? See here, let us explain. I sigma L1, how it is? I is the current flowing through the wire, sigma is the resistance per unit length of the wire, and L1 is the length of the wire AP1. So sigma into L1 gives me the total resistance of the wire, and current into resistance is equal to voltage, and resistance of the wire of length L1, that is equal to sigma into L1. So I can say here I sigma L1. In your new syllabus book, we have considered here E1 is equal to K L1, and that is equation 1. That equation I sigma L1 is also important. We can say E1 is equal to I sigma L1. This is important for the calculation in some problems also. I is the current flowing through the wire, sigma is the resistance per unit length of the wire, and L1 is the length of the wire. Sometimes the total length of the potentiometer wire is given, that is suppose L, and the total resistance of the wire is given. So total resistance upon total length, that gives us the resistance per unit length, that is sigma. So this is for the calculation. Now come to our point again. We have connected here the closed key K1, and E1 is in the circuit. Now in the second part of the experiment, the K1 is open. We put the key K1 as open and close key K2. Now E1 is not in the circuit and E2 will be connected in the circuit. Again we touch the jockey at different points on the wire and obtain the null points. Suppose your null point is here P2. ऑब्वियसली देखो यहाँ E2 जो है इसका डैनियल सेल, उसका वोल्टेज फर्स्ट सेल से कम है, इसीलिए हमारा नल पॉइंट भी ये P1 से पहले आएगा. लेंथ जो है वो कम आएगी क्योंकि वोल्टेज कम है. इज दैट? नाउ मेजर द लेंथ ऑफ द वायर AP2. सपोज द लेंथ ऑफ द वायर AP2 इज इक्वल टू L2, कुछ भी होगी वो लेंथ. वी कैन मेजर विद द हेल्प ऑफ मीटर स्केल गिवन ऑन द वुडन बोर्ड. A यहां तक 100, और फिर यहाँ तक 150 और 140 एनी लेंथ ऑफ द वायर वी कैन मेजर इट इन द सेंटीमीटर AP2 इज इक्वल टू N2. अगेन वी कैन से बाय द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ पोटेंशियोमीटर द EMF ऑफ द सेल सेकंड सेल E2 इज बैलेंस एंड हियर वी गेट K इनटू L2. दिस इज योर इक्वेशन 2 एंड नाउ वी कैन कंपेयर द EMF ऑफ टू सेल बाय टेकिंग द रेशियो E1 अपॉन E2. हमें कंपेयर करना है मीन्स हमें रेशियो लेना है E1 अपॉन E2 इज इक्वल टू KL1 अपॉन K इंटू L2. अगेन K गेट्स कैंसल एंड सो वी कैन से E1 अपॉन E2 इज इक्वल टू L1 अपॉन L2. दैट इज द सिंपल फॉर्मूला फॉर द कंपेरिजन ऑफ EMF ऑफ टू सेल बाय सेपरेट मेथड एंड दिस इज द कंपेरिजन ऑफ EMF ऑफ सेल बाय सेपरेट मेथड. If we use this formula here, we can say E2 is equal to I sigma L2. In both the cases, again I sigma will be same and that will get cancelled. And we can say E1 upon E2 is equal to L1 upon L2. For the board theory question, you can simply draw a circuit diagram. And by writing a simple theory and by using these three formulas, you can find the final result. And your result is E1 upon E2 is equal to L1 upon L2. As L1 is more than L2, we get the ratio positive. अगर E2 is less than E1, यहाँ E2 less than E1 होगा, तो हमें L2 ज़्यादा आएगा L1 से, then that ratio will be less than 1. So we choose, that is the precaution in this experiment, that the cell having greater EMF, choose it as E1, and the cell having less EMF, choose it as E2. And then we can compare the EMF of two cells. Okay? In the next video, we will see the use of potentiometer to compare the EMF of two cells by sum and difference method. Thank you.